Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about creating SAS datasets using a raw data. So how you can do that? Before going that, I will give you a brief revision of referencing a SAS library. So suppose if you have SAS library where SAS datasets are saved in outside folder, how you can give reference while accessing any existing datasets, or if you are interested in saving some new datasets in particular file, so how you can do that. So for doing that or giving a SAS library reference, you have to use libname statement. So libname statement has three parts. One is keyword, libname keyword, and then libref. Libref is basically referencing your library and connecting your library with this name. And after that, you have to provide the location of that folder. So suppose this is my folder, input folder, where all the SAS data sets are saved here. And if I want to get an access of this folder, and if I wanted to access of any of these SAS data sets, so you have to first define this folder, and to get an access of this library, you have to provide a lib reference and this location. So the location you can easily get, clicking right hand side and go to the property, and you can copy that location from here, and you can paste that locations inside the quotation mark. So this location should always be hard coded. So in that case, it will connect this lib reference with this, folder. And the same way I connected this libref with this folder, so this will going to be my out data. So out data, any data set that I'm going to create will save in this folder. So suppose if I'm reading this data set, an existing data set, and creating this data set here, so what it does actually, it will read this library information from here, and then this will read my data set here, and this new data set will be created in this folder actually. So this is how it works. So let me run this program. So lib reference, first you have to provide that for in and out data set, and what it does actually, it will read the an existing data set, and it's creating a new data set in this folder. So you can see that in output folder, you can see a new car 18 SAS data set is actually created by reading an existing data set. This is how you can give reference of a SAS library. Coming to the point, how we can get an access of a raw data file. So suppose if you have some raw data file, for example, in my computer, you can see, so there are some raw data here, actually text_2. So you have to remember that raw data for, accessing, we have to use file name statement. So file name statement is, very similar to the libname statement. It has also three parts. First you have to write the keyword, file name keyword, and then you have to write the file ref. File ref is very similar to libref. Like, it will connect, this file with this location. So, and after that, you have to provide the location of that folder or file here, and it should always be hard coded. It should always within the quotation mark. So this is how these two references are similar, but there are some differences. You have to always remember that. So in libreference, you don't have to use the name of the file actually, the data set, but in file name statement, you need the name of that data set actually. So for example, I'm copying this one, so you can see name and type is also included here. So when you copy this one, so I'm copying the exact raw data file, not the folder here. That is the difference between that. And now this file ref is now connected with this file actually that is saved in outside folder. So this is how you can use file reference for existing, to connect or for giving reference a raw data files that is saved in outside folder. And for reading that, I have to, before going to run the actual program, I will explain you about the raw data, for example, here. So raw data always should be in fixed field. if you are using file name statement, because for example, you can see the first variable that is taking this much space. The second record is also taking the same space. Yeah, you know, you can see there are some, empty spaces is always there. And the second variable started at the same position, actually, if you see that. So it's not moved here, you know, immediately after, you know, completion of this record. So this is always in a fixed space. If it is not in fixed space, it will give you some kind of error and data error. And I will explain you, you know, later in my program. So you can see to get an access of that file, you have to use in file statement. So in file statement basically identify the external file. And after that input statement, you have to write to identify the basically describe your data. So what will be the data information? For example, here we don't have any variable name. We don't have, you know, what kind of variable is character or numeric. We don't have that information. We have records only here. So one records, two records, and maybe hundreds or thousands of records can be included in this raw data. And after that, if any new variable, if you are interested in creating, you can do that. And after that, you have to write output statement, and then you have to complete this program with run statement. So when you run this program, what it does actually, it will read raw data file and create actually. So this is first I have to run this actually file name statement. So file name statement, you have to run. Now your file reference is connected with this data set. So when you run this program, what it does, it will create a new data set with these records, and a new records is also, you know, included here. So this is how a file name statement works. And if you can see that, as I told you, if your data is not in fixed field, it will give some error. For example, here we have another data set, and you can see that if I'm opening here, so this data set is not fixed field. You can see the, you know, first records, this is second record. So this, you know, variables is ending, and immediately after one space, second variable is started. It's not fixed field. So ideally, it should be just below 61. This value should come, and this 175 should come below 122. So that way that data should be actually, but it's not that way. So in that case, if you run the program for getting that kind of data, program will still run, because this is not a syntax error. This is a data error, but you can see that, you know, your data is not reading properly. So you have to go back and check your, you know, output, you know, every time when you are running your program, and if you are using this statement, that if you are getting right, you know, data or not, and you can fix your program accordingly. So here you can provide the, you know, length of your variable, you know, and you can do that, you know, what length is that, and this is how your data should always be in fixed field. So this is very important to remember. And after that, in this video, I'm also explain you about SAS expression, like how you can define expression in SAS programming. For example, transforming any variables, creating new variables, as I already showed you here, how you can create a new variables here, BMI. And also for conditional processing, like if you are certain conditions to create a new subset of data, or if you are interested in calculating new values or assigning any new values. So for these kind of expression, you need operators. So in SAS programming, there are two operators. One is arithmetic, and second one is comparison operators. So arithmetic operators are for doing mathematical, you know, operations or calculations for like addition, subtraction, multiplications, and exponentiation. Those kind of things you can do that. And it is recommended that you can use parentheses to control the order of operation. So there should not be any kind of confusion when your program is running. And comparison operators is for, you know, selecting any specific variables and specific values and giving any conditions. For example, if you need certain records with this name, you can give name, and the character variable should always be quoted, you know, hard coding. And if you are interested, for example, temp variable need to be not equal to 122, you can give like all the variables with 122 values will be excluded, or if you are interested in like greater than. So this is the operator you can use in programming. And what it does that it will include only those data which has value of income variable greater than 20,000. So this is how you can do comparison operators, and you can use multiple operators together if you have two different condition, and for that you can use AND operators. And for in AND operator, what it will do, it will if both expression are true, then the comparison is true, and then output will come actually. And if you are using OR operator, then if any condition is true, then compound expression will come and it will show in your data set. So I will show you, like for example here you can see I am going to read this data set class 19, and let me turn off all of these conditions from here. So what it does actually, when you run this program, an output data set will be created. And now I'm giving condition one by one here, like using some operator. So I'm going to calculate actually the same variable height, and I wanted to increase my height with basically 10%. So what I will do that I will redefine my height variable. If you can see that height is 69 in first record, so I wanted to increase 10%. So you have to write the variable name, and again the this is the new variable that will be created. You can give a new name as well, but I'm creating the same variable, and this is old variable, the height that what is already existed, and this is height, and I'm multiplying with 0.1. And you can give 10% if you are interested. You can write this, and as I said, I am going to increase the 10%. So what will this will do that when you run this program, you can see that height values will be changed here. You can see that it was initially 69, but it's showing here now 75.5. So this is how you can use operator. I use here equal sign. This is an operator, and this is the plus, this is multiplication and division. So this is how different arithmetic operators were used in this program. And if you will give further condition, for example, if you are using another creating another new variables here, like you can see BMI, and I'm using this formula, you can see. And so what it will do when you run this program, a new variable BMI will be generated, and it will do calculation, and you can see at the end a new variables is coming. So this is how you can play with that. And at the end I will show you, I'm giving a condition here, like if gender is equal to M. So I'm interested only in in gender is male actually. You can see that here. So there are total 19 records are there. So when you run this program with this condition, so only records with gender M will comes. And after that I'm also creating another variable here. So another variable I can tell you later on, maybe after running this program. So when you run this program, you can see, so only selected variables where the gender is male is comes out of this program. So this is how you can use different operators, giving conditions, equal sign or greater than. Or suppose I am also writing where a weight is more than 100. So you can write that if weight is greater than 100. So let's run this program, and you can see that difference. So you can see that only program where the weight is more than 100 will come. So this is how you can use these operators, either it's comparison operators or it's arithmetic operators. So this is how you can use this. This is very useful, and you have to use these operators throughout your SAS programming. And last part I wanted to define you about reading in-stream data set. So in-stream data, when you are defining your values within, you know, a data program. For example, this is the data set I am interested to create here, and this is the input, you know, statement where I'm defining my variables. So for character variables, you have to define a dollar sign here if you are, you know, if you're writing a character. And if you are a numeric, you know, variables, you don't have to really define anything. You have to just leave it blank. And here I'm putting dollar because I'm defining these variables as a character variables. And you know, after that you have to write cards statement, and instead of cards you can also use data lines statements as well. That will also work. And after that you have to write all your records here and end with semicolon. So this is one statement basically, and then you can run this program. I'm going to delete this one for it will not create any confusion. So what it does, it will read this in the stream data, and you can see that this data is also, you know, equally spaced, and it's in fixed fields. So it's not like that some data has like this more space and some has less. In each record are equally spaced actually. So this is basically a fixed field data. So that is very important, you have to remember. And when you run this program, a new data set will be generated, you know, with all those values are coming under, you know, you can see that these are the variables name, age, sex, and INI, and these are the name and age. Each records are coming perfectly. So this is how you can write a, you know, raw data using in-stream data. And these information are very critical for SAS programming. And hope you will like my video, and please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much for watching.